We all need water. No matter where we live on Earth, water is important. But billions of people do not have safe water. They live in developing countries and they often get sick from their water. Even in our country, sometimes we think the water is safe when it really isn't. The early warning biosensor looks for dangerous bacteria, viruses, parasites, and pathogens in the water. It all started when NASA scientists wanted to see if there was life on Mars.
Scientists thought there were life on Mars because there are polar ice caps. And polar ice caps tell them that there could have been an atmosphere on Mars millions of years ago.
They needed a way to look for life, so they used something called carbon nanotubes. A carbon nanotube is a tube of graphite, like a pencil. Look at a human hair. A carbon nanotube is so small, it is 1/50,000th the diameter of a human hair. Scientists can grow them to a few millimeters long. Even though they are very tiny, they are very strong. NASA scientists used carbon nanotubes to collect strands of DNA on Mars. The DNA would tell them if there was life on Mars because rocks don't have DNA, and Mars has lots of rocks. The scientists didn't find life yet, but they still feel it's possible.
Thinking about it, it's amazing that technology they used to find life on Mars could find viruses here in the water on Earth. Here's how the early warning biohazard sensor works. You take a sample of the water you want to test. You put in the biosensor device. Then you watch a couple of spin-off videos, and in a couple of hours you get the results. But a lot of science went into making it this easy. Take a disease, for instance, cryptosporidia. You want to know if it's in the water because it can make someone sick or even kill them.
Scientists put half a strand of DNA on the carbon nanotubes in the biosensor. The biosensor goes in the water. When it comes in contact with the bacteria it's looking for, it takes the half strand it needs and binds it to the half strand it already has. This makes a complete DNA double helix. Then it sends an electrical signal to tell us that the disease is present in that water.
One thing that makes the early warning biohazard sensor so great is that it can be used anywhere. The biosensor doesn't need a big lab to work in, and it doesn't need much energy. Sometimes we buy fruits and vegetables that are grown in other countries. How do we know they're safe? The health inspector can test the food by simply washing it off and testing the water with the early warning biosensor. They could tell food was contaminated, and that would save lives. It helps farmers by testing feed water for animals. Healthy farms makes healthy people. Food and beverage companies can use it to test water in their products. People in poor countries could really use the early warning biosensor because they don't know if their water has germs or parasites in it. The early warning biohazard sensor is simple to use. You don't need a big laboratory. It hardly needs any power, and you get results in 2 or 3 hours instead of days or weeks.